this video, we're going to go through the assembly of a Detroit Diesel inline 671 long block model RC. By buying a long block, you will save time on the engine assembly process since they already come timed, calibrated, and assembled by certified Diesel Pro Power technicians. A long block includes an engine block, crankshaft, connecting rods, cylinder kits, camshaft, balancer shaft, front counterweights, timing gears, front and rear end plates, complete cylinder head, mechanical injectors, injector fuel lines, and front top cover. As you can see, we are going to assemble an RC configuration long block. RC means the engine is going to be a right-hand rotation, and the camshaft will be installed on the right-hand side of the engine if you were looking from the back side of the engine. The technicians are going to start by inspecting the Diesel Pro cylinder kits. While one technician opens and inspects the cylinder kits, the other technician proceeds to do the liner fitting into the block. The technician is marking each cylinder liner as he fits them into each cylinder borehole.
Cambiaron motor y
que no hay.
With a specific tool, the technician is confirming that the piston crown has the correct compression ratio for the application. The technician will bore the cylinder holes for proper liner fitting.
Yo se lo había dicho.
Thank you.
Next up, the technician is assembling the pistons. He is installing the piston pin retainers with the proper tool. After finishing the piston pin retainer installation, he proceeds to do the vacuum test to ensure there is a proper seal and there will not be any leaks. The technician is removing the main bearing caps to prepare the block for crankshaft installation.
Watch your finger.
The Technician proceeds to install the main bearings. Be aware that there is an upper bearing and a lower bearing. Always look for the marks identifying them. After installing the main bearings, he installs the thrust washers into the main bearing number 7.
Esto tiene una posición, loco. Yo lo que. Pero yo, esto, mira. Yo lo que, wrong. Ok. Hello.
Mechanics are adding international compound to the main bearing bolts to prepare them for installation. After preparing the main bearings and main bearing bolts, the technician proceeds to install the end plates. Please note that he inserts the camshaft end bearings to use as a guide for the proper installation of the end plate. With the gasket in place, he proceeds to install the front end plate. The technician prepares the connecting rod bolts and spacers to bolt the connecting rod to the piston. He proceeds to bolt the connecting rods to the pistons. Please note that he will apply the correct torque to the piston bolts with a torque wrench at a later point. Here the technician applies the correct torque to the piston bolts with the torque wrench. Now the technicians proceed to install the crankshaft. Technicians proceed to verify that the crankshaft oil gallery has all the correct plugs installed. If any of these plugs are not installed, the engine will experience loss of oil pressure. 5 plug, 6 plug.
Okay, complete.
Mechanics, proceed to install the upper thrust washers. Please note the lower thrust washers are already installed in the main bearing. He proceeds to install the main bearing number 7, including the lower thrust washers. technician sets up the torque wrench to proceed to torque the main bearing bolts. Always refer to your service manual for the correct torque specs. The technician proceeds to install the piston rings.
Check colectando.
The technician confirms the height of the block deck. The technician proceeds to install the crankshaft timing gear. While one technician is installing the timing gear, the other technician installs the liner inserts.
Okay.
The technician proceeds to torque the timing gear bolts. With the piston assembled to the connecting rod and the piston rings in place, engine oil is applied to the piston rings to proceed to place them into the ring compressor and then into the liner. The technician proceeds to install the wood rough key into the camshaft. The technicians are verifying the connecting rod bearings. Now he proceeds to install them. Be aware that there is always going to be an upper and lower bearing. Once the cylinders are assembled, they proceed to install them into the engine.
Los aires que echan los ventiladores, eso es caliente. ¿Vale?
Porque mira cuántos ventiladores hay arrancados. Mira cuántos ventiladores hay arrancados. Y esta nave está abierta. Está abierta. Mira. Es que esa lucha me cae en calor. Esa luz se mete mucho calor. Esa luz se mete mucho calor.
Each rod that is installed must be torqued.
Así que aquí te le ponen a las pastillas, tiene que ser con comida.
Si es en Cuba no puede ser con comida.
Sí, no, aquí te le ponen en la
bandera.
Dale, dale, pon el 2 si quieres, para sacar la bandera ahí.
Sí, sí, vamos a ir por su orden.
El 2.
Dale.
Ponen ahí comida, con comida. No sé qué dicen, tú le dices, no, para meter un pedazo de pan y bajo de poco, un buche de agua atrás ya.
No me bajó, ¿sí? No me bajó, ¿qué me dicen? ¿Qué me bajó?
Le doy vuelta para el uno.
Guys, this will be it for this video. Please check out our part 2 where we will install the camshaft, the gear train, and the cylinder head.
Thank you for choosing Diesel Pro.